Becky did well and on past twice 30 years. I crave a little of your time to tell of me hopes and fears. I am a single lady and I think it no disgrace, for my life's been spent in honest toil and work in the Honiton Lace. A cottage near to Axminster is the place that I call home. My father left it to me and it's the one thing that I own. I rise each morning at the dawn when the sun first shows his face, for that is when the light is best for work in the Honiton Lace. At 9 o'clock I go down to the shop and I take me work. My friends are gathered there and we can spend some time in talk. We get paid off in tokens we can use just in that place, for their value is but fivepence for a day at the Honiton Lace. Then Mr. Groves, he gives to me a pattern for to do. Sometimes there is a harder piece that must be done by two. So me and Bridget Harvey, we sit in her window case, and we spend a pleasant day a-chatting and working the Honiton Lace. There was a young man who spoke kindly unto me, but he became a soldier and he was lost in the Crimea. He was me only suitor and no one has took his place, and so never for myself I'll work a veil of the Honiton Lace. But sometimes when the night draws on, I'll let me bobbins fall, and I'll think the piece I'm working on some lady at a ball. So all you London ladies whose fine clothes are worked as grace, just you think on those Devonshire women who dressed you in your fine Honiton Lace.